So now there's actually two different ways that alkanes can become unstable. The first one, and probably the most difficult to explain, is the shape, okay? There's just this rule in organic chemistry that a straight chain is going to be less stable than a branched chain, all right? Where does this come from? Actually, this is a topic of hot debate, and there's actually research going on right now to figure out why straight chains are less stable than branched chains. It's not something that's talked about in your textbook very much, and all I would say is, like, it has to do with very, very complicated things. It has to do with stuff that's well beyond the scope of this course. So what I would say is, instead of trying to understand it, just memorize it. That a straight chain, if I had a 6-carbon straight chain, and if I had a 6-carbon branch chain, okay, the actual, we're not talking about intermolecular forces. Intermolecular forces, if you're thinking of van der Waals forces, that's something completely different, okay? That has to do with what state of matter it's in. I'm talking about actually how energetic it is, like how much energy it releases when I burn it. That is going to be higher for the straight chain, and that's going to be lower for the branch chain. Why? Because the branch chain is going to be more stable, the straight chain is going to be less stable. All right, so that's just something you should know. The second thing is strain. There's actually a lot of different types of strain. I'm going to talk about two right now, but there's actually even more than that.